nuestra siguiente entrevista, Wayne Berger, CEO de IWG Americas, Estados Unidos, Canadá y América Latina, conversará con Viridiana Mendoza, editora de reportes especiales en Forbes México, sobre el futuro del espacio de trabajo flexible.
Amigos, ¿cómo están? Mi nombre es Viridiana Mendoza, soy editora en la revista Forbes México y les quiero dar la bienvenida a esta charla como parte del foro Forbes Real Estate 2021, la reinvención del modelo inmobiliario. Estoy muy contenta de poderles presentar a nuestro invitado porque sin duda su firma es una de las más importantes a nivel global en términos de espacios de trabajo y pues tengo que switchar al idioma inglés porque nuestro invitado pues nos acompaña en esta conversación desde Canadá. Entonces me gustaría presentar a Wayne Berger, CEO of IWG Americas, United States, Canada, and Latin America, and he's gonna talk to us about what is the future of the flexible workspace. Thank you, Wayne, for being with us in this conversation.
Gracias, Viri, and I really appreciate the time, and thank you for accommodating my English. I appreciate it to you and your viewers.
So tell me, Wayne, about this pandemic just put an immense pressure on the flexible office space. So a lot of people just went to work from home. And this is not seems like to be like changing like a trend or we are not seeing this different and not in the immediate outlook. So what do you feel is the greatest advantage that flexible offices spaces can provide for a company today in the market?
That's a great question, Viri. So you are exactly right. Over the last 16 months, we've all been working towards battling this COVID-19 pandemic globally and certainly in Mexico and across Latin America. And it's had pressure within the co-working, flexible workspace industry and certainly in other industries and sectors as well. And we've been focused in a tremendous fashion at pivoting our business to make sure that we can continue to practice and move forward. And one of the things that I'm very proud of is all of our locations have been open throughout the pandemic because our business is deemed an essential service. So we've been able to support those clients and organizations that need flexible workspace during this time. Now, to your point, we've also seen this world's largest and Mexico's largest work from home bubble take place over the last 16 months as well. Many people have had an opportunity to be very productive working from home versus going into an office traditionally. We all can recall the long commutes that we've seen back and forth through major cities like Mexico City and Guadalajara and Monterrey. And much of that commute's been eradicated with giving people the opportunity to work from home. Now, what's interesting is the future when it comes to co-working and flexible workspace looks extraordinary. And I mean that without bias. Now, prior to the pandemic, more than 50% of the world's workers, especially knowledge-based workers, which represents about 2 billion workers, were working from somewhere other than a corporate headquarters for at least 50% of the work week. And flexible workspace and co-working was growing dramatically right up to March 2020 to help accommodate this large percentage of workers. What's happened during the pandemic is we've all been forced to work from home. And what people are discovering is that there is tremendous value in having more flexibility. Now, what's interesting is surveys are showing that only 13% of people want to go back to a traditional corporate headquarters 5 days a week. And only 20% of people want to work from home 5 days a week. Although working from home has been valuable because people have been able to be productive, people have had more time with their families. And imagine living in places like, for example, in Mexico City, where you could potentially eliminate a four-hour commute every single day. That gives people back time to focus on energies in their job, and then also with their families, their friends, other extracurricular items. So people are seeing the value of being able to work flexibly, but there's a real fatigue in working from home. So when we look at the future of flexible workspace and co-working, today, co-working only represents about 2% of the commercial real estate market in Mexico. But we see tremendous growth because people are now shifting. There's a revolution that's taking place in which more and more people have worked from home for the last 16 months, and they now want the ability to be able to work closer to home to enjoy the benefits that they've learned, which means that there needs to be more flexible workspace locations and co-working locations located throughout Mexico and frankly, throughout Latin America. So we see tremendous growth opportunity ahead when it comes to flexible workspace. And it's starting now, because although we're still managing through the pandemic, we are in the later stages of the pandemic. Vaccination rates are increasing across Latin America. And companies starting September, October will start to think, how will they redeploy their employees back to what we call an office? But there is a concern from employees about being able to get there safely. And we want to make sure we do this in a very well-positioned approach, which means we're seeing companies start to deploy what we call the hub and spoke model, giving their employees the ability to work from somewhere, whether it's home or at a location of work closer to home versus having to travel long commutes. So it's a very exciting time in our industry.
Yeah, I think we were forced to work from home, and that create like a lot of distortions for in the good way. We start to enjoy our time at home, but in the other side, we start to feel like we are like in a jail at home. And now I think with this transitioning from 100% remote to person work at the offices, we are seeing like another opportunity of having different spaces of work. I would like to ask you, what impact do you think this will have in the long term for office spaces market? Mm. I think companies are gonna have the chance of having people like in other cities working like in the daily basis functions. So what do you think is gonna be the long term trend for this phenomenon?
Well, here's a few trends that we're seeing. Number one, there's a real democratization of work that's taking place today. So companies, whether they're based in the United States, Europe, Canada, or in Mexico, or anywhere else around the globe, know that they can now access talent beyond just their local market. So for example, if you're a great worker in Mexico who has skills that can be applied across companies, your ability to access a job has just expanded. And I'll give you a good example. Facebook, based in Palo Alto, California, moving forward, has now committed that every single one of their job openings is available for anybody in the world. They don't have to actually reside in Palo Alto. And that's one example. So suddenly, I think one of the trends we're seeing is the ability for companies to access the best talent, regardless of where talent lives, is at a greater state today than ever before. So this access to great people is now opened up, because the idea of going to one location every single day is really becoming the thing of the past. That's one element. The second element that we're seeing is we're going to see a reset in the commercial real estate markets. And it's all dependent on different markets, but we're expecting to see this trend take place in places like Mexico City, perhaps in some other secondary markets as well, as companies are starting to reevaluate their real estate portfolio. So companies like HSBC have come out recently stating that they are going to reduce their real estate portfolio upwards of 40%. Now, they are not alone. Companies are starting to look at their real estate portfolios on a global scale and a local scale. And what they're doing is they're asking themselves, where do we need to continue to maintain our own company real estate? Because flexible workspace and co-working is not alone over the last 16 months where we saw workers in the office greatly diminish. Companies have realized that the offices that they rent under a traditional lease have sat empty for the last 16 months. And many of the employees that used to travel to those offices and work every single day, they're quite happy. And in many times, more productive and more engaged working from home over this period. So what companies are starting to do is they're starting to evaluate their real estate portfolio. This presents significant savings for organizations because the real estate aspect of a company traditionally is either the top or the second highest cost associated to a company's balance sheet. And if you look at IFRS 16 principles, those leases are now listed as liabilities on a balance sheet. So what happens is companies now are looking to keep their corporate headquarters, repurpose, maybe reduce the space at their corporate headquarters, but also redesign it for a new type of work experience. And then they're also looking at the periphery of the real estate portfolio and starting to reduce leases either through force measures or on natural lease terms. And they're reducing the amount of space. And this is becoming quite common in Latin America, where companies recognize there's great value in accessing a strong knowledge-based workforce and also a strong consumer market, but they're looking to de-risk as well. So they're working with flexible workspace operators and co-working operators to provide workspace, but frankly, at a fraction of the cost and at zero capital investment because they're just signing a rental agreement. So that's another trend that we're seeing is more and more companies reevaluating and frankly, reducing the real estate portfolio. The third trend we're seeing is this movement towards the environment and health and wellness. Health and wellness has never been more critical in the workplace than what we're seeing now. So what we're seeing today is companies taking measured steps to ensure that their employees are happy, healthy, and engaged, because there's a real battle for talent that's taking place around the world. And a happier, more engaged employee means they retain those employees. And one of the top indicators that we're seeing from employees that they're looking for in a job is the ability to have a flexible working strategy. 77% of companies have established a flexible working strategy moving forward starting September, which means the 23% that haven't are going to lose great people. So those are three trends that we're seeing financially, benefit-wise, and then as well, just the nature of how people are working.
And Wayne, in terms of the real estate market, it seems if the current market conditions favor no more tenants than other persons, more tenants than owners. So how do you, as a flexible workspace provider, deal with this trend specifically in Mexico and Latin America? How do you think you can get advantage of these conditions?
Well, we're looking to grow our business exponentially across Latin America and especially in Mexico, and not just in Mexico City, but in Guadalajara, Monterrey, and also other cities like Mérida, Tijuana, the northern coast cities. We're looking to provide an expansive network across Mexico. The reason why is because we see the demand in each one of those cities. People are looking to work closer to home. We've seen people move out of large metropolitan cities and want to have a different work-life balance, have a different cost structure element. So we see this opportunity right now as incredibly valuable and very opportunistic. Now, there's a few things that we're doing today. One, we've seen greater opportunities for partnerships with our landlord partners and with Fibras throughout Mexico. Because the need for flexible workspace is becoming more prevalent, not just with workers, but also with landlords and institutional investors, they recognize that parts of their real estate portfolio needs to be linked to flex because that's what their tenants, both international and domestic tenants, are looking for. So we're seeing the opportunity to grow and add new Regus and Spaces locations across Mexico, but doing it in a partnership way, which actually requires very little capital on behalf of our organization, the capital invested by the landlord, but in turn, the landlord reaping the rewards by driving a higher than market rent through the profits they would receive by having IWG operate that flex space or co-working location. So we're seeing more opportunity. And part of that's because vacancy rates are increasing. So landlords need to become more creative, and also because their tenants are asking for more flexibility. So we see this as a great opportunity. I actually anticipate that we will sign very few capital leases moving forward, and it'll be more around partnership agreements and franchise agreements with FIBRAs, landlords, and also franchise investors.
This is a flexible era for all of us after this pandemic. And I would like to ask you about what are the main benefits for business owners and their employees to have flexible workspaces. Because I think you mentioned before, like the financial aspect and also some of quality things, but what do you think are the real main benefits for business owners from these trends about flexible workspaces?
Well, one of the first benefits, and I'll reiterate it, is financial, and it's a hard cost savings. Companies that place their employees in a flexible workspace or a co-working facility versus signing their own lease and investing all the capital associated with building out that space can save anywhere from 25 to 40% true hard cost dollars, which is extraordinary, right? So the savings is significant. Now, there's also savings for employees, because if an employee has the ability to be able to work closer to home, it helps them save money on commuting, on all the costs linked to public transit, and also all the associated costs that are required traveling to and from work. So there's savings there for an employee as well. So the hard cost savings is significant. The next benefit is flexibility. Imagine if you're a company. Traditionally, you would have to sign a 10 to 15 year lease depending on the market condition. And you're locked into that lease for that period of time. And that lease needs to be capitalized on your balance sheet. Let's say your business shifts in 3 years. You still have 7 years left on the lease. You now have the ability to be able to have much more flexibility. So our clients in flexible workspace and co-working have the ability to sign a lease as little as 1 month. They can access space for a day. And we've had many international clients come to Mexico signing multi-year leases with us or multi-month leases with us, and then pivot their business, be able to move different locations without any penalty, and also transition in and out of the rental agreement. So the flexibility is significant because it unleashes capital for the organization. Now, when you can unleash capital for the organization, that gives the company the ability to invest more money into people and other research and development, which frankly helps benefit Mexico and Latin America and its citizens, as well as employability, right? So it's a great opportunity to see a company invest actually into infrastructure and innovation beyond just paying a lease. So there's tremendous financial benefit. The other benefits, though, is one, it gives people the opportunity to get more hours back in their life. If an employee can eliminate 2 to 3 to 4 hours a day that were just traditionally spent traveling via bus or metro, et cetera, to get to an office, only to put their laptop and their cell phone down on a desk to start working, it's incredibly unproductive. And it also has a deep impact on the environment as well, with CO2 emissions from lengthy commutes and long car rides stuck on highways. So there's an environmental benefit with the ability to be able to work 5 to 15 minutes closer to home. And that could be a bike ride or a walk versus these long commutes. So there's a great opportunity for health and wellness. And what we've been seeing and surveys have discovered from employees is that it creates a more productive employee, a more engaged employee, and a happier employee, which means productive, engaged, happier employees drive a higher profit for organizations, and it reduces turnover, which means higher retention. So it helps the company benefit dramatically. The last piece I'm going to add in is the future truly is hybrid and flex. We will continue to leverage technology. Technology has become a great enabler, but we're social beings and we miss each other. So the opportunity to get back together in an office with our peers is really powerful. And I think many of our viewers, I know I do, I miss it every day. So that opportunity of gathering doesn't always need to take place in the traditional corporate office. A corporate office will become a destination location of which people will travel to maybe once a week. But when they go, it's going to be a great experience. The experiential value will increase because we're not just going there any longer to drone through the day working on daily tasks. Now we'll have the ability where work will be ubiquitous, where you can work from wherever you need to based on what's required for the day. And you can gather at a flexible workspace or co-working location and meet your peers, meet your clients, or frankly, connect with other companies, which helps you network, which helps you grow your professional network, your personal network, and maybe create some new business while you have the opportunity to engage and interact again with people in a live social setting. So the benefits are really strong and powerful when it comes to the ability to be able to access and utilize flex space versus just maintaining a traditional corporate real estate portfolio.
I think all the things that you are saying are like a win-win relation for the future in terms of hybrid work. But one of the main concerns for companies, especially here in Mexico and Latin America, is this model is going to work for my culture organization? So how does IWG create a successful, flexible work schedule culture? How the companies can actually have a culture that works for their organizations?
It's such a great question, Vidi, and I'm thrilled you asked it because it is one of the biggest question marks that leaders have when they start thinking about the future and how people work together. What's interesting though is you take a look, very rarely did organizations work on culture every single day in the office. If you think about it, culture is captured by a relationship with somebody's manager, by a relationship with their peers, when they have the opportunity to gather together, almost in that tribal setting where they're gathering for a town hall or a team meeting or an innovation session. That's where culture starts to get infused. It starts with induction and then it's ongoing with team relationships and team building that can happen in a meeting or in a gathering. So what companies are looking at is they're determining, A, how do we make sure we keep the culture alive in our company and grow in our company? And how do we do that in a live setting and also utilizing digital technology? You know, being a manager requires a greater set of skills today than it did prior to the pandemic. Because as a manager and as a leader, you need to be able to make sure you're connecting really effectively, utilizing technology as well, because technology was an enabler in the past, and it's only going to become a greater enabler moving forward. As we move to 5G technology and our ability to be able to exchange millions of data, that levels of data across from each other, just utilizing our cell phone, creates a complete game changer. The tools that we're using today, like for example, today we're on Zoom. Zoom will look very different in 2 years and 3 years from now. It'll become more immersive. It'll become more 3D rendering. It'll be less the screen experience that it is today. So technology will continue to accelerate and advance. So companies now are looking at how they deploy culture. And what they're recognizing is culture doesn't need to be established and managed by having everybody in an office 5 days a week. As a matter of fact, when people are together, that's when we need to make sure they're being purposeful in creating culture. So what many companies are doing is they are providing a new flex schedule for their employees because their employees are saying, we see the value in not traveling to one corporate headquarters every single day. As a matter of fact, it's unproductive, right? So companies now are bringing their employees together, their human resources team together, and their leaders together at the same table. And they're defining how they're going to work moving forward. And what they're asking their employees is to say, look, schedule your week appropriately. If you have time, that's needed to put your head down and just work on productive activities, reviewing contracts, reviewing different types of work that just, where just you need that independent time, feel free to do that from where you would like to be able to do that from. That could be from home. It could be closer to home at a co-working location or a flex space, or it could be at the office. If there's time that you need to be with your team members, schedule that appropriately and gather together, whether it's live once we get through a pandemic or digitally. And then we would like you to be at the office at our corporate headquarters. And maybe that's once or twice a week, so we can have a chance to engage together, to meet together, to talk about our mission, our vision, our objectives, to meet one-on-one with one's manager, or to gather together with a team to innovate and connect. Because we know that innovation and collaboration works best when everybody's together. So what's happening is that's how culture is becoming more infused today. It's not about the notion of just everybody being physically under one roof all the time, because when we are, we don't meet all the time anyways. We're usually doing one of those three things as it is, right? So instead of always doing that now in one location, let's give our employees the ability to be more purpose-driven and not make work-centric with place. Make it more ubiquitous. So then when we have to gather together, that's how a culture gets accelerated and created. It's empowerment, it's involvement, it's value, and it's high experience. And that will create a better culture for an organization than just the nature of traveling back and forth every single day to one office.
Yeah, I think those are changes that we are really hopeful to see in the future, in the near future, in this coming back to the offices and in this coming back to the work, new normal work mm-hmm. way of having this environment. So to finish, I would like to ask you, Wayne, which are the advices that you can provide to people that are interested or are just thinking about, what if I try a co-working environment? What if I try a flexible workspace? What if I, what would be the advice for these people that are just thinking about trying for the future? Yeah,
it's a great question. So the first thing I would recommend, Vidi, is if you're interested in trying a flexible workspace or a co-working location, the first thing I would do is go tour some different locations. Take the time, reach out to them. Every flexible workspace location, whether it's a Regis location, a Spaces location, or a local provider in Mexico, they'd be happy to receive any potential client for a tour. When you walk into a flexible workspace location, it's hospitality first and productivity second. So what potential clients will experience and witness is this really wonderful immersive experience. But it's important to tour because different flexible workspace locations and different companies offer different types of experience. And that type of experience can be modeled around what you're looking for specifically, how your personality is based, how you like to work, the type of work experiences you like to have. And I'll give you a good example. In Polanco, we have our newest location, Spaces Torre Concreta. That location is at the top of a brand new tower in Polanco. It's absolutely beautiful. It's got a gorgeous rooftop patio. It's got a great club experience with a cafe, phone booths, team rooms, and then of course, a collection of private offices. It gives a worker seven different types of work experiences to be able to have their day. If they want to work outside, if they want to work indoors, if they want to be with their team, if they want to be independent, they have access to all of those options. And they also have access to the best street tacos in Mexico down right across the street. I promise you that. Now, right down the street, we have our Regis. We have another one of our Regis locations that will have a different type of experience. It's a little bit more business. It's a little bit more business traditional. It's got a wonderful team, but it's a bit more of a, private, more exclusive environment than what we see at Spaces Torre Concreta. So two great locations, two very different locations. So what I would recommend to your viewers and people interested in trying co-working and flexible workspace is go tour different locations, meet the teams, ask the teams what types of companies share this space, because that is also a value for a company who's looking to be around their peer group or maybe grow their business. And then also have an opportunity to see what the amenities are around that location as well. What matters to you as an individual? Do you want something that's close to home? Do you want something in a vibrant downtown environment? Do you want something like our Regis in Cancun, which is in the hospitality district versus the downtown district, right? So it's really about the best workspace that fits your personal needs and your professional needs. So I recommend tour, talk to the team, meet them, ask them what their values are, ask them the types of clients that are experiencing, and also find out what your access is to other locations beyond just that one location. Because we will be traveling again. We will have clients in different cities, in different countries, in different neighborhoods. And some co-working providers who have a larger network give all of their members at any location access to all locations. So that becomes another benefit as well. So those are some things that I would recommend to your viewers.
I think it's interesting, this phenomenon, because it gives to all business the opportunity to be as they want. I mean, you don't have to be in a startup to have a modern workspace, and you don't have to be like a very huge corporate to have like a very, very serious space to receive a client that is going to have a serious deal with your enterprise. So I think it's a wonderful opportunity for all the business owners to have the chance to have different kind of workspaces and in the stage they are, right?
You're exactly right. Whether you're a freelancer, which is a growing population, to a startup, to an enterprise location with some of the largest global companies, right through to a mid-cap company, what's provided here is a better experience, a hospitality experience with some of the newest and most innovative types of build outs at a fraction of the cost that your employees will love. It truly is a win-win-win. And then the biggest thing as we move through a pandemic, if we can all do our part to play a key role in helping really drive change in the environment, it's very, very powerful. If we can eliminate, eradicate, or greatly reduce CO2 emissions, it helps our world for future generations while we give people a better work-life balance, which helps companies drive greater productivity. It truly is a win-win-win all around.
Great. Well, Wayne, thank you so much for this conversation and for your time to participate in this event. And I think you told us like a lot of interesting things. I think the opportunity for enterprises to save like 25 to 40% of the cost are very important. And it's like, it's gonna be like a focus on the next steps after this pandemic. So thank you so much for your time. And I hope this is not the last chance that we have to speak about this topic, because I think the trends are gonna be interesting in the next months.
I agree, Vidi. Thank you so much to you and the team for your time. And I wish all of your viewers all the best as we start to transition to this next phase of the pandemic. And I can't wait to see all of you either digitally or live again. Thank you so much for the time.
Thank you. Amigos, muchas gracias por acompañarnos. Como bien lo dijo Wayne Berger, CEO de IWG Americas, quien nos explicó mucho acerca de cómo va a ser la realidad en este periodo post-pandemia y en este regreso a las actividades laborales en unos modelos híbridos y flexibles que no solamente van a beneficiar a los empleados y a la calidad de vida de nosotros como trabajadores, sino a las empresas en sus balances financieros y en sus índices de productividad. Los invitamos a que nos sigan acompañando en este Foro Forbes Real Estate 2021, la reinvención del modelo inmobiliario, en el cual seguiremos conversando sobre cómo será el futuro para los espacios de trabajo. Muchas gracias.